Hello friends, today we are going to see how to convert a normal array into a zigzag array. So let's see what is a zigzag array first. Now, see this array is a zigzag array. You can observe in this array 5 is less than 10, then 10 is greater than 8, 8 is less than 12. 12 is greater than 6, 6 is less than 9, and 9 is greater than 4. Here you can see this less than and greater than operations, they are alternatively placed. So a zigzag array is such an array in which the elements follow less than and greater than order alternatively. Okay. So here I have written C. These are the indices. So element at 0th index is less than element at 1st index. Then element at 1st index is greater than element at 2nd index. Then 2nd is less than 3rd. 3rd is greater than 4th. 4th is less than 5th. 5th is greater than 6th. So in short, in zigzag array, the elements are alternatively less than and greater than each other. So let's see, as we have seen this example, let's see this. See here, 8 is greater than 4, 4 is less than 6, 6 is greater than 3, 3 is less than 5, 5 is greater than 1, 1 is less than 10, 10 is greater than 9. So this is a zigzag array. You can see in a zigzag array, these three elements as A, B and C. Then you can observe B is greater than both of its neighbors. Means B is greater than neighbors. That is written here. B is greater than A and B is greater than C. Again, for C, you can see if we consider this element as B, then C is less than its neighbors. So C is less than its neighbors. So that is just one condition written symbolically for you. So as now we have understood the zigzag array, we will see how to convert a normal array into a zigzag array. So just by looking at the numbers, if the numbers are very less, then we can convert this array into zigzag array very easily. But if there are thousands of numbers in the array, then it may be difficult to convert. So we have to have some algorithm for that. So what is that algorithm? So the first step in the algorithm says that just keep the first element as it is, because the first element has only one neighbor. So you cannot compare the first element with its previous element. So we just keep that element in the array as it is. So let us keep that. So keep the first element. Now the algorithm starts. I have written here, see, I am going to use a flag. That means whenever a flag is 0, the current element should be less than the next element. And whenever a flag is 1, current element is greater than the next element. And this flag is alternatively going to be 0 and 1. It will change alternatively. Okay, now see here, suppose first the flag is equal to 0. So when flag is equal to 0, see here, ith element, that is 0th element 3, is less than 4. So the property for flag is equal to 0 is satisfied. So we don't do anything here and we just move to next element. See, all this procedure is going to be done in a while loop, for example. So inside this while loop, I is going to trace the element from 0 to n minus 1, means to the size of the array. So when I is 0, it will compare itself with the first element, because I is 0, I plus 1 is 1. So 0th element is less than 1, yes it is, and flag is 0. So the property for flag equal to 0 is satisfied. So let's increment I, and after incrementing I, you have to change the flag. See, flag is equal to not of flag means that you have to make the flag 1 if the flag was 0, and you have to make the flag 0 if the flag was 1. It is like a flip flop. So it will alternately change from 0 to 1 and 1 to 0. That is written here, flag is equal to not of flag. So currently the flag is equal to 0. So after we enter the while loop, we have checked the first element, we have incremented I, and now we are changing the flag. So the flag will become 1 now. So when the flag will become 1, I must be greater than I plus 1, because the flag is 1. So I is greater than I plus 1 is the property. See here, whether I is greater than I plus 1, no, it is not. So when it is not satisfying the property, you have to swap the elements. You have to swap I and I plus 1. You have to swap the elements when it is not satisfying the property. So swap 4 and 6. So 6 will come here and 4 will come here. So let's write it here also. 6 and 4. Okay. Now increment I and change the flag. Now I will write flag here. See, currently the flag was 1. Now the flag will become 0. Okay, so the ith element should be less than the next element, but 4 is greater than 2. So again swap. So 2 will come here and 4 will come here. Okay, so after we swap 2 and 4, change here in the output array as well. So it will be 2 and 4. I'm just writing the output here. Actually, the procedure is being done in place. It is in place. I am just writing the output here. Otherwise, consider everything in this array as the final output. Now, so let's increment I and change the flag. So it was 0, so now it will become 1. So 4 is greater than 1. Yes, it satisfies the property. So increment I and flag will become 0. 1 is less than 8. Yes, it satisfies the property for 0. I is less than I plus 1. Yes. So increment I and change the flag. So 0 will become 1. 8 is less than 9. Yes, that does not satisfy the property. So now you have to swap the elements. So 9 will come here and 8 will come. Okay, so now increment I, but as I is the last element, you cannot compare it with any next element. So the loop will be over and you will come out of the loop. Now let's check whether this is a zigzag array or not. See, 3 is less than 6. Yes, 6 is greater than 2. 2 is less than 4. 4 is greater than 1. 1 is less than 9. 9 is greater than 8. Yes, this is a zigzag array because less than and greater than operations are placed alternatively while checking it. This is the way how we convert a normal array into a zigzag array. I will write the output here 1, 9 and 8. And remember, this is an in-place procedure and the time complexity for it is O of n. In O of n time complexity and constant space complexity, the array is converted into a zigzag array. Hey friends, please subscribe to my channel as I post algorithm videos every day. And if you want a video on any particular topic, then please mention in the comment below. Thank you.